We've been showing these flood inundation maps numerous times over the past few days, and this map is indicating a 23-foot crest in the Cedar Rapids area. It extends from Palo down to the Highway 30 bridge. So we'll start off in the northern part of that area. Around Palo again, when things get to 23 feet for that crest coming up tomorrow night, would expect that to be hitting the Drake neighborhood, or rather the Drake Drive neighborhood, back toward Lincoln Drive, Thompson, around Lynn Drive as well. Kind of on the southeast side of town is where I would anticipate some of that flooding to take over. Also on the northeast side of town where Blair's Ferry comes into town, there's a gas station up there. Flood water gets generally to about First Street as you come into the town of Palo. Heading downstream, we have a lot of those parks and other just nature areas that would be affected as we head downstream. Heading down towards Seminole Valley Park, also going to be seeing water taking over that area. There are a couple of neighborhoods along the river as we get closer to Edgewood Road. Coming up this evening, there is a full expectation that Edgewood Road Bridge is going to get closed. That's right here at 23 feet. The water is going to be covering up the approaches to that. They, of course, plan to close off that access before that becomes an issue. As we look farther downstream along Ellis, we continue to see some flooding on there. This spills into Cedar Lake and affects areas underneath 380, close to Coe College. So close to Coe Road is where we would see some of that flooding take place by tomorrow night. Also in the Time Check neighborhood, from the river all the way back just beyond Ellis Boulevard northwest, perhaps as far west as 9th or 10th Street, we would see that potential for flooding. One thing I want to mention, too, is this assumes there are no things that are able to keep the water back, assuming no HESCO barriers, assuming no sandbagging. If things go according to plan, this area in blue will actually be a little bit less than what we would show on this map, just because those precautions would be taking place. Closer to downtown, we do see that extending a couple blocks on the east side of the river, also covering up the approaches to the 1st through 3rd Avenue bridges, also extending west of the river all the way up to about 6th or 7th Street. Heading farther downstream, we've been talking a lot about the Czech Village area as well as Newbo. At 23 feet, we extend that, see that extending pretty much encompassing all those areas. That'll be an issue that we have to watch for. Again, though, there's been a lot of sandbagging and preparations going on in those places, and we can hope that'll hold in those areas. We'll head a farther back downstream here, looking back toward Prairie Creek. We've taken a lot of questions about what are the impacts in that area. Prairie Creek will back up. We're already seeing some flooding around the Jones Park Golf Course, also near the Tate Cummins Park. That extends back off toward the west, and eventually the impacts aren't quite as strong as you get back towards 6th Street Southwest. We'll probably be approaching 6th Street Southwest, but whether or not it'll flood there remains to be seen. We'll also back off toward the east just a bit, closer to Highway 30. Full expectation is Highway 30 will remain open. However, at 23 feet, it does get close to Highway 13 north of the interchange there. So we'll have to watch 13 coming up later on tomorrow night. But one thing is very confident is that we will not have issues on Highway 30 or 380. Those are going to be your main thoroughfares across the Cedar River, both north, or rather through the city of Cedar Rapids, as well as east of Cedar Rapids. We go now to the west side of the river. Jordy is joining us now with an update.
Talking
a lot about the flood inundation maps in recent days. Thankfully, in Independence, we've already crested, so we're going to focus in Cedar Rapids now, and this extends from Palo all the way down to Highway 30. And one of the questions we've gotten a lot of is, what are the routes that are still going to be open? Well, over the Cedar River, Highway 30 is still going to be fine. 380 is well above the river, so that is also going to be fine. One place that may be in question, depending on how things are going to evolve here with the crest, would be potentially Highway 13 on the east side of town. Once we get to 23 feet, it starts to get a little bit closer to that Highway 13 area out toward the Bertram area, so that'll be something to watch carefully. But again, Highway 30 as well as Highway 30 and 380 are going to be just fine from that particular standpoint. We're going to take a little tour here and show you some of the areas affected at 23 feet. Again, we'll be watching Highway 13 kind of extending up some of the little tributaries up there. Heading upstream, water treatment plant, totally fine. That was put into place that it was 3 feet above the 2008 level. So the water treatment plant will be just fine. Looking up Indian Creek, it does rise up and back up some as you head up toward Mount Vernon Road. But in Indian Creek Park, north of there, it starts to stay within its bank. So north of Mount Vernon Road, it should not cause too many significant issues from it backing up. As we head back along Old River Road and Otis Road, there are going to be some issues, especially in the Rompott neighborhood. We're going to be keeping an eye on that. Also, there are going to be backups along Prairie Creek southwest of the river, out toward Tate Cummins Park. There's the power generation plant as well that we're going to be watching, as there are going to be some rises in that area and probably some road blockages around C Street, if I had to guess, in that particular zone. That also extends back off toward the south and west. Industrial areas back toward Bowling Street between 30 and 33rd Avenue. There are some of those industrial areas that will probably have some water trying to creep out of the creek there. And then as we look back off toward the west of 380 along Prairie Creek, once we get to about 6th Street Southwest, it doesn't come out of its banks as much. Those of you who do take 6th Street Southwest, though, want to follow things over the coming days and be aware that there could be some delays in that particular area. Heading back upstream along the main part of the Cedar River, we are going to be, of course, watching out toward the Czech Village area, pretty much between the river and C Street Southwest, as well as Newbo. That'll be taking on some water. And one thing I want to mention once again, we've talked about this a little bit the past couple of days, these flood inundation maps assume that the water can go wherever it's going to go, where there's assumption of no HESCO barriers, no sandbags, no other berms or anything like that. This is a worst case scenario at 23 feet. With some luck and with all the work that people have been doing, the actual area covered in blue will be a little bit less because of that protection that's been going on. So that'll be something that we have to watch for over the next couple of days. Moving back toward the downtown area, on the west side of the river, from the river back toward about 6th or 7th Street Southwest, that is an area that we do anticipate that flooding to extend to. I drew a line there at 7th Street Southwest. A couple of blocks into downtown as well, perhaps as far in as about 3rd Street or so, 2nd, 3rd, perhaps even as high as 4th Street, depending on how things progress here. But again, that is assuming those barriers do not hold, but things are looking good so far. Heading up to the time check area, this is taking a look between the river and Ellis Boulevard. Looks like the water would extend back toward Ellis in most places, could get as far west as 9th or 10th Street along some of those streets, but primarily to the east of Ellis Boulevard Northwest, where would be the inundations taking place. Moving back a bit farther upstream, it hugs really close to the river, also going to be watching it spreading beyond Cedar Lake. Edgewood Road Bridge likely to be closing this evening. That's the plan from the city of Cedar Rapids. Has a 23 feet. That is going to be inundated along the approach on the south side of the bridge. So that is going to be getting closed off as the water continues to rise there. Not surprisingly, much of Ellis is going to be dealing with that flooding as we look back off toward the northwest as well. Usher's Ferry area, Seminole Valley Park, going to be taking on water as well. We'll keep on heading to the northwest toward the Palo area, zooming out the view here. Much of this area is more in the way of nature, forested areas, but as we get toward Palo, again, we're going to be watching for that to be affecting that area, especially south of Blair's Ferry Road. We have the gas station up there on the corner of 1st and Blair's Ferry, down at the end of Main Street as well. And as we head back toward the neighborhood on the southeast side of town around Drake, Lincoln, Thompson, and Lynn are going to be other areas that we're going to be watching for with that flooding as we eventually creep up toward 23 feet coming up later on tomorrow night. Of course, it'll take some time for this full inundation to take place, but as we go along, more and more places are going to be experiencing that flooding.
Meteorologist Justin Gehrts went out today to check on river levels along the Wapsipinicon River, which also continues to flood.
Justin, what did you see when you were out touring today?
Well, certainly a lot of high water yet, but Bruce and Beth, it appears the Wapsie upstream of Anamosa crested just a bit earlier today. This is how the river looked in Central City this afternoon. You can see how much water was coming past the roller dam. Had quite a strong current as it headed downstream. Now, while still quite high, the Wapsie there has begun to pull back just a bit from some of the houses in the lowest sections of town. It's also still flooding the park along the east side of the river, though. Meanwhile, in Wabik, a couple of roads were closed because of the flooding. The water came near FB and Company, but stopped short of the building. Some good news there. And as we move into Jones County and Stone City, the river appeared to have very recently crested. The water didn't quite make it at the bottom of the deck of the general store. The current was pretty swift there, too, where swirls kept forming just down to the bridge, coming past the pylons. Some houses had a bit of water in town, but more significant flooding has affected Stone City Road as well as the homes west of town. Good news is that, again, the Wapsie has crested in these places. Watching the crest in Anamosa coming up for tomorrow.
That came close to getting to the bottom of the deck.
Very close,
I'm
sure. A lot of people wondering what things are like with the general store. Happy to say that it didn't quite make it there.
All right, good. Thanks.
Thank you.